Hey, what's up, you guys? This is SGB618 here, and today I wanted to talk to you guys about Spider-Man Miles Morales and why I'm so hyped up about it. We saw the PS5 showcase the other day, and it showcased quite a few games, and some of those games actually got extended, you know, gameplay, and Spider-Man was one of those games, which I'm really happy about. I think Spider-Man Miles Morales is probably my most hyped game this year, and I'm just glad that it's going to be here day one on PS5. But what are some of the things that I really like about it already? Without further ado, let's just go straight into it. Okay, so let's get the obvious out of the way. The graphics are quite good. Just like the first game, the graphics look pretty good. However, one thing that I really do like is the whole seasonality thing that it's got. Unlike the first game, Miles Morales has a sort of winter theme going on, which is quite cool because it distinguishes itself from the original, and obviously that means that the lighting in these settings is going to be quite darker, again giving the game a different feel from the original, so you don't really feel like you're playing the same game again or a direct copy. You see what I'm saying? I just like how they still kept the whole movie-like effect. And this is actually linking with another thing that I like about this game. Very similar to the original, but the transitions between cutscenes and actual gameplay is super smooth. Like, literally the first one that we saw that was in the showcase, I didn't even realize that it transitioned. Like, it just went towards the back of Miles Morales, then I was like, oh snap, it's gameplay now. But I felt like with Spider-Man specifically, it was very, very smooth in the way that they transitioned the cutscenes and gameplay. And I just hope that they have that throughout the game. I just think it's a very nice touch. And it just makes the games feel that more realistic and up to date. And then talking about movie-like effects again. Obviously, this game has QuickTime events like the original, but they're not the bulk of the game, to be honest. They're more of just like making the scene more impactful and more intense, which I don't mind. I think it's quite cool, and plus a lot of these sections really like boost your adrenaline and get you excited. Literally, whilst I was watching the extended gameplay, I wasn't even playing it and I was like, oh, what's gonna happen next? So the game really sets a really good tone, and Insomniac did a really good job of like building a really good setting, good environment and good atmosphere and stuff like that. So once you get the viewers hooked like that, you've already done a pretty good job there. So, and then we got the characters. Obviously we don't have a lot in terms of the new characters. Obviously we got Miles himself. The costume looks so cool, by the way. I wonder if they're actually going to have multiple costumes like the last game. One thing that caught my eye was the fact that Insomniac decided to go with the Tinkerer for the main villain. And I actually think that's a really cool idea. Not a lot of people know who the Tinkerer is because they're not like a super well-known Spider-Man villain. But that also went for Mr. Negative as well. So you're sort of creating curiosity in the audience because they're going to be wondering who those characters are, which will then draw them to play the game. For those of you who don't know who the Tinkerer is, he was actually like sort of a minion character in Spider-Man Homecoming. He was one of the guys who was working for the Vulture in that movie. And they've completely redesigned the character in this game. The Tinkerer is female in this game and is wearing a technological suit and is actually going to be fighting in this one, instead of just being in the background sort of working on weapons and whatnot. So I think that's really cool, and I'm glad that they didn't just get a regular villain that's been done to death, and is a villain that's going to bring a lot of attention to the game based off of how little people know about them. Can we just take a minute to talk about that bridge scene? That bridge scene was absolutely crazy, dramatic, and it really got my attention. I was actually kind of annoyed that that extended gameplay ended at a time where I wanted to know what happened after that. And again, that's Insomniac winning because obviously consumer curiosity, which is obviously key to selling a product. That bridge scene looks really cool, and it sort of sets the tone for the game, at least psychologically it does, because obviously we never know what's actually in this game until we actually, you know, play the full game. But just based on that, it had fight scenes. We had a look at the villain on that bridge scene as well. We saw graphics being put in. We saw Spider-Man's abilities. We saw invisibility, electricity, and obviously webs. We saw quick time events as well, which, yeah, I know some people don't like quick time events. I feel like it really does set the scene and it doesn't make the viewer feel bored just from watching a cutscene. It really makes you feel like you're Spider-Man, because obviously you need to mash buttons and press buttons in time as well in order to save people and also to, you know, fix things on the bridge as well. And obviously it's tense because it's Spider-Man versus all of these guys, and then you need to fight against everything that's crashing towards you, and then you need to rescue people as well. Now, I just felt panicked and anxious just watching everything that was happening, like with Miles on that bridge, and it really made me feel like I was there. So I was just really excited, just based off of that bridge scene alone, because it really did set the scene. And I just hope that the entire game is like that, because if it is, then it's pretty much going to capture everyone's attention for the entire thing. So there you have it, guys. Those are some of the reasons why I'm super excited for Spider-Man Miles Morales on PS5. Comment down below your thoughts on everything that we've seen so far on the game, and let me know if you're going to be picking up this game on day one with your PS5. I'll be very interested to know. Anyway, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.